do you think?
I think a lot of things. I try not to think because it hurts too much.
It hurts to think?
Yeah.
How come?
It's easier to just paint than think. If I think, when I paint, then I don't paint. I spend too much time thinking.
Thinking about what, though? What you're going to paint?
I don't think about what I paint. It's just simultaneous. I think a lot better that way, because if I think too much, you know, me, I have too many hang-ups. So, I need to get out of those hang-ups so I can paint. Otherwise, forget it. You know, I'll be sitting there going, oh, this color doesn't go with that color, it doesn't work this way. If I use spontaneity, I'll pick out some of the color.
So your mind is blank when you paint?
No, it's all full of all kinds of stuff. But it comes out there instead of looking at it. So, I don't know. It's weird when if I sit and think, it's easy for me to start with something blank. If I sit and think about it too long about what I'm going to paint, then I usually get in the car and go out and cappuccino because it's just forget it, I'm not going to get there. But if I just stretch a canvas and get to work, then I paint. Painting is like there's part of life in it and what goes on around the planet and stuff and what happens, and part of it's what's me. And you know, no matter how far I try to get away from the painting, I am the painting anyway. So there's not really any, I can't totally leave the painting. Each painting is unto itself, even though there are a series. And you know, like, take the life series, it's like the impact of the life series, what people have on that. When you look at what I do, what I hope to get is a reaction, whether it's good or bad, I could care less. When you get tired of looking at something on the wall, it's dead, then it's no good anymore, might as well throw it out, you know. And I think that it should be my paintings give emotion. Okay, whether one woman looked at it, she said, "Boy, you must be angry. I see a lot of anger." And I was with three people, and they said, couple of jazz musicians, you know, a rock star, you know, they're like, one guy saw music, another guy saw something else. And I said, well, you better take a look, maybe the anger's in you. And she left. And that's what my paintings do. A lot of people say they're real sexual. Some of them are very sexual paintings. I don't see them as sexual paintings. But my philosophy is to make the world a better place through my art. That's my main deal. So there's a fine line between like what really goes on and what we see go on in life. You know, it's like we think something else is going on. Instead of being right here, right now. It's human beings who tend to do that a lot. And I'm somewhere in between about what really happens and what you think happens. That's my work, somewhere in between all that.
How long have you been painting?
I think that being an artist is something that you do, and it's the hardest profession in the world. And when you make a conscious decision to be an artist, you know, it's like I hear people say, yeah, you don't have a choice, you know. But to me, any of my other professions bore me. And the thing about creating something that wasn't there, you know, if I wanted to paint nature, you know, or landscapes or cows or something. God does that. I don't have to do that. You know, He does cows and trees and sunsets and all that stuff. I'm going beyond what I know. I'm always looking for farther out, more exploration. How far can I take this? How far can I bring this red? If I put a red over here, what happens? If I put this blue next to this red, what's going to happen here? If I put this figure next to this, what's going to go on? How complex can I get it? The colors I work with, people look at me and say, you know, how do you do this? The colors I work with are intoxicating. If I spend too much time working on some of the fluorescents that I use, I literally get intoxicated just by the color alone. All that humongous power, all that energy, and it's like, how do you control that? So that when I look at it, it's a powerful piece, but it's not overpowering at the same time. I think I've taken the realm of color as far as I can take it. As far as I can take it. I think I've just been, and now it's all the complexities, and what do I do with it from here? Where do I go? And I like, you know, I like using the reflective surfaces, and I used to be limited to just paint, and now I use whatever I can find. If that requires building something, like my new series of all the multi-panel pieces, I'm going beyond. I want to see how far I can bring it. And I don't know where it's going, I just know it's going, and I'm driven to do that. If I stay in one style, one series too long, or one style too long, it gets boring and repetitious. And therefore, the spontaneity gets lost in the translation. Listen to what other people say. And just because some critic doesn't like it, or some people don't like what I do, or whatever, it's just what I do.